Dr. Eric Topol is a cardiologist and professor of genomics at the Scripps Research Institute. His new book is called The Creative Destruction of Medicine, How the Digital Revolution Will Create Better Healthcare. Dr. Topol, thank you for being here.
Oh, it's great to join you.
I want to talk about the title of your book. First of all, The Creative Destruction of Medicine. What does that mean?
Well, it's a term actually from an economist from the last century, Schumpeter, and how the world can be Schumpetered in medicine. Radical innovation that really transforms the future of healthcare and medicine. And basically, it's because we have this digital infrastructure, which is so incredibly developed, you know, not only with smartphones and bandwidth and connectivity, but also supercomputers and cloud computing, social networks. So if we just harness that opportunity in the healthcare world, which has kind of been in its own cocoon, finally, we can change the whole course of how medicine will be practiced in the years ahead.
So give us some examples of how sort of the digital age can affect our health.
Well, you know how devices like smartphones and tablets change our daily lives radically. Well, what about if that was healthcare? So, for example, you're checking your email and you're surfing the web on your phone or your tablet, and all of a sudden you can check your vital signs, your blood pressure, your glucose. You can also look at your DNA and how it might react to a particular medicine that you could be prescribed or just was prescribed. So there's all this remarkable knowledge about each individual. There are new tools, new rules for how medicine will be practiced.
So is this information, are these tools that you want the consumer of health to have access to, or you want the physicians to have access to?
Well, the physicians can have access to, but it probably won't change their practice. So I think it has to be consumer-driven for this to really take off, because it's one's own, the ownership of the smartphone where all this data is going to be. DNA, it's, you know, it's your DNA. You have the right to have access to that. And so the medical community, for the most part, is very resistant to change. In the book, I talk about it being sclerotic or even ossified, like bone. Whereas the consumer is much more plastic and flexible and willing, because they're so vested in their own health, to take that that active role, that participatory role, and with their own platform of a smartphone or their genome, they can actually make a big difference in how their health care is, their health is preserved.
Is it a little bit dangerous for us, the consumer, maybe the untrained consumer, to not really understand what all of these things mean, whether it be how our blood pressure might fluctuate throughout a day or a week, our glucose levels, that we might be armed with information we really don't understand?
Right. Well, that was the argument with the internet back in the 90s. Oh, they're going to, people get all this information and they're going to go, you know, really nutsy and become cyberchondriacs. And, you know, we got through that. But this is very different. That information was about the whole population. Now we're talking about the individual's own information. If they have high blood pressure, it's their blood pressure from beat to beat. If they have diabetes or pre-diabetes, they want to prevent that progression, it's their glucose every minute on their phone. So this is a whole different world now. It's not the internet of the whole population. It's for each person. And I think this is going to make a big difference. Now, could it engender confusion? Sure. But that's why you still need the medical community to interact with, you know, to help get guidance. But to have access to information like we've never had before, these tools were not available.
So why don't doctors want us to have all this great information?
Well, it's kind of threatening. But moreover, it's because the medical profession is extremely conservative. And so, you know, it takes 17 years for an idea, historically, to be actualized in day-to-day clinical practice. We can't wait 17 years. This is something that could be so helpful, transformative, innovative today if we just allow it to happen. It won't happen via the medical profession, but they're critical to helping implement it properly.
Dr. Eric Topol, thank you for being here. The title again of your book, The Creative Destruction of Medicine, and where can people find out more about your book, or where can they get it?
Well, they can get it on any of the websites, Amazon, and iBooks, Barnes & Noble, and I think there's been, fortunately, a lot of great reviews, and it's off to a really great start.
Great. Dr. Topol, thank you.
Thank you.